I'm going to describe how we can determine kinetic parameters using nonlinear regression. If we run a plug flow reactor and we measure exit concentration of reactant as a function of volumetric flow rate, so we're essentially changing the residence time, so we're changing the amount of reaction. Looking at a simple gas phase reaction, catalytic reaction, we use an Excel spreadsheet for the calculations. I'll show you the details of the Excel spreadsheet in a separate screencast. And here we want to overview how we go about doing this. So here's the rate expression. It's an expression you expect for a surface reaction being the rate limiting step and catalytic reaction. So the rate's proportional to the surface coverage. And so we have two parameters, the rate constant and the adsorption equilibrium constant. So these are two parameters we're going to determine with nonlinear regression. And what we're going to do is go through the approach and the steps we use in this screencast to give you an idea, because this takes several steps within Excel to accomplish this regression. So the first step is we're going to solve the mass balance for ordinary differential equation for plug flow reactor. We're going to use fourth order Runge-Kutta fixed step size, and we're going to be able to do that in Excel. You might say, well, you could do an analytical solution for this particular case. But if we want to look at the general case, much easier then and only practical to do numerical solutions. So we're going to fix the reactor volume, but then we're going to use V as our independent variable. So at the inlet of the reactor, we say at the inlet volume is zero, and the feed concentration, this is for a pressure of 2 bar and a temperature of 450 Kelvin. And the way we're going to do this numerical integration is stepping through. So we're going to say at a small distance down, 0.05 cubic centimeters, the concentration at that location is our feed concentration. And then these four parameters, K1, K2, K3, and K4 that we calculate, multiplied by our step size, so this is dV, and then divided by 6, where these K terms are the rate expression. K1's evaluated at the inlet. K2 is to account for the fact that the concentration actually changes slightly within, of course, that small dV. And K3 and K4, these are just the approach used for the Runge-Kutta integration. So this is the first step. And then, of course, the similar idea as we step through the N plus 1 step, we use the concentration that we calculated at the previous step, and the same calculation where again we use the concentration at that previous step to get the K values. So won't go into any more detail. Runge-Kutta calculation, there are screencasts that describe this approach in more detail. Well, here's the critical thing that allows us to use Excel, is that we're going to create a data table that allows us to calculate the exit concentration as a function of the volumetric feed concentration for different volumetric feed concentrations. So this, of course, assumes we know the parameters and we're going to guess them. And so that means that solving the differential equation for each of these volumetric flow rates in Excel will do that and substitute the values in the table. So using a data table is critical for being able to do this calculation in a reasonable way. And I'll show in other screencasts more about the data table. And then we have to actually guess values for our two parameters and then do a nonlinear regression by using Excel solver. And that's minimizing the sum of squares of the difference between our experimental measurement of the exit concentration and our calculated value. And then finally, we're going to calculate confidence limits from this spreadsheet. This also will be described in a separate screencast. So I'm going to just show you the screencast to give you an idea where we have our parameters here and we're minimizing the sum. And I'll describe this in more detail in a subsequent screencast so that this doesn't become too long and we miss the overview. If we carry this out, here are the two parameters we determine. If we use a smaller step size, so what I showed you was for step size 0.05. If we use smaller step size, 10 times as many calculations, now we get the same values. And so there's no advantage to that smaller step size. And in particular, when you realize that it's only really these first two digits that matter when you look at what the confidence intervals are. So the spreadsheet to do these calculations, like I mentioned, I'll show in more detail in another screencast. But I'll just finish here by showing our model and our experimental data and showing the fit is very good for these particular parameters.